going on? It's Vince Geddes, a health insurance guy where I help individuals, business owners, as well as families build the best benefit plan that you can find anywhere else. And today I'm going to talk about the dangers of self-funding your own health insurance policies. Now, health insurance, the benefit of having health insurance is that if anything were to happen to you, it's going to allow the insurance company to transfer that pain, transfer that bill out of your pocket to the insurance company's pocket. That's the whole purpose of insurance, is transferring the risk from one party to the next. Now, if you don't have health insurance, I'm going to tell you how this jacks up generational wealth through and through. Now, if you don't have health insurance, I can guarantee you that you're going to either get sick or you're going to have an injury that's going to most definitely happen in the near future. I just got done lifting weights at the gym. I'm taking care of my body. I injured my back. I've been out of commission for a couple of days. Went to the doctor, did a quick physical. They told me to take a couple of naproxen and sit my butt down. But because I had an accidental injury policy, I'm going to get $400 back, which is cool, you know, because, again, my body, I look at this body as being a commodity, so I cover everything on it, and that accidental injury policy only cost me $20. But because I am the health insurance guy, I know what's available out there, so I want to give you guys the game on the different type of policies that are out there for yourself. But let's get back to the subject as far as self-funding your own health insurance. So a lot of people don't know that one day in a hospital could cost 10 grand. You break a leg, that's $7,500. Also, COVID, the cost of COVID, just the treatment of COVID, is between $20,000 to $50,000. And the average American, 56%, middle-class American, has less than $5,000 in their bank account. So what happens? Somebody go to the doctor, whatever happens, a lot of us are not paying that bill or skipping on that bill. And when we skip on that bill, what they do, they throw it on our credit report. And when they throw it on our credit report, that's going to make a whole heap of trouble, because we all know that this whole world is governed by credit. If you go to try to find an apartment or want to get an apartment in a certain area, if your credit is jacked up, you can't get that apartment. If you're trying to purchase a home, if your credit is jacked up, you won't be able to get that home. If you're trying to get a bank loan in order to do some sort of business, we're talking about truck drivers. I'm going to give you guys that game, because I know a lot of truck drivers that are working for companies that want their own truck, but they always tell me, yo, Vince, man, I don't have the credit right now. You know, I try to put them on funding, but they still got to have credit in order to pull the trigger. I don't have the credit right now. Why you ain't got the credit, man? I got a couple doctor bills on them. But again, they didn't have health insurance, and a lot of them have bit the bullet and just said, hey, I'm not going to worry about it, and it sits on your credit report. Now, with medical bills, if you don't know, it's similar to student loans. Them bad boys ain't going nowhere. They will sit on your credit report for a long time. We're talking about 7 years of hindering you from living the life that you want to live, hindering you from the business opportunities that are out there. Also, when you do have a low credit report, what they do? They push you and redline you. They put you in certain areas, whereas other people who got bad credit, the other people who don't care about the credit. And also, when they put you in these areas, you got to think zip code. What if you have children? But if you have children, you can't go to school on the other side of town. They're going to say, hey, you need to go to schools that are in your zip code. And then you go to schools in those zip codes where it's less opportunity, less options. Your kids are going to get less opportunities and less options. This is a generational thing, right? This is a generational thing. I can honestly say, as far as like looking at my own child, that we live in the suburbs. We lived in a, well, I ain't gonna say we never lived in a hood, but we lived in the suburbs. And it was one point in time when, it was kind of a separation or whatever, where my son had to go to a crappy school. This was in Decatur, and that school was absolutely terrible, but it was based around the zip code. They didn't have, you know, the schools were overpacked. They didn't have certain, you know, books that were available to the school, to where we used to go to. And they didn't have certain technologies that were available, which was like, you know, totally, it was terrible, you know. But this is the daily life of children in the inner city. I grew up in this, you know. So I don't want you guys to just think that I'm just trying to market health insurance. I'm looking at a whole nother perspective, because health insurance is just what it is. We're talking about insurance. We're talking about covering and protecting everything that you worked on, everything that you have. I always tell people that say, well, I don't need health insurance. When you get sick, we're going to find out, you know, how important health insurance is. You may have money, you get sick and you go to the doctor, we're going to find out how much money you really don't have, because the doctors could eat up all of your savings, eat up all of the money that you've been saving, eat up your 401k. We don't want that. I want you to make sure that you got your money in your pocket so that you could do whatever the heck you want to do, take care of whatever business you need to take care of, because your body and your body is the most important asset that you have. Protect it. That's why it costs so much money for health coverage. That's how I cost so much money for health maintenance, because the doctors, they understand how important your body is. Put some value on it. Put some respect on your name right here. Put some respect on you. So if you are looking for health insurance, you can reach out to me at www.getnextdayhealth.com. That's www.getnextdayhealth.com. Book an appointment with me there, or you can call me at 404-689-2322. That's 404-689-2322. Don't let a medical bill get on your credit report and then hinder you from the opportunities that are available today, because there's a lot of opportunities that are out here. You may be a truck driver. You might need a truck. You might need a new home for your family. You might need a business loan in order to go into that business with a partner that could have something cutting edge, but your credit is jacked up, so you can't do it. So let me know if you need some health insurance, so we don't have to worry about that, and you can focus on the other things that's going on in life, because we're in 2021, walking into 2021. In the next few weeks, the new year should be better than 2020, because coronavirus was tearing everything up. So give me a call if you need health insurance. Talk to you later. Bye.